All right, good evening, everyone. I am Animesh Damani. We have a very shortened panel from the original one, and quite a few of you all are still here for the last panel. So we'll try to make it a bit interesting, right? Quite a few topics to cover. Before we start, I'd like to have a small introduction from my co-panelists. We can start with Mr. Dani. But
good evening, everyone. It's about to likely to be evening starts by this time. The last bencher can come forward for a happiness of all of us. Well, my name is Manesh Dani and I am representing Rotomag Motors and Controls Private Limited. Predominantly, we are into the renewable energy, and as an engineering company, we are here, wherein we will be contributing or sharing about our viewpoints on the renewable energy, mainly solar pumping systems, inverters, and the efficiency and efficacy of the renewable energy in time to come.
And Mr. Abhishek?
Hello, friends. I'm Abhishek Avrani from Abhishek Enterprises. We are EPC for rooftop, majorly into residential rooftop.
I'm Animesh Damani. We run a company called Artha Energy Resources. We're a data-driven technology company with interest into advisory services, consultancy, and also we have launched a platform for ESCO projects to invest into C&I. So without any further delay, I'll just start on with this session. A couple of topics that were already discussed, we'll quickly run through them. So regarding this entire Make in India concept, right, there's been a lot of push from the central government to create capacities within the country. However, despite multiple tenders from SECI with manufacturing linked to development of assets, we have not seen that go through. Finally, we have seen Azure bidding out for it. Considering the fact that the annual installation is estimated to be about 10 gigawatt per year for the next 3 to 4 years, assuming all the SECI auctions and state auctions that are bid out are actually built up and not accounting for any major addition into rooftop solar. We already seen the manufacturing base in the country is much, much smaller than that. So what is the opinion of my fellow panelists with regards to the fact that A, we do not have sufficient manufacturing capacity to meet our own demand, number one. Number two, in terms of technology, it's already been established fact that we are way behind China in that front. Number three, that in India, we're still primarily focusing on assembly of the modules, right? The vertical integration that comes with silicon and the entire ecosystem around it has still not been focused on the government side, still not been developed, apart from a cell manufacturing plant that is run by Adani's. So what are your thoughts on that?
As it has been said, and it's a matter of concern for a time to come also, as renewable energy business is booming or the domain is very prosperous, it shows a lot of good prospects also. Modules and all, if I understood your question very correctly, that it has got its own service life of 25 years by this time. And in this condition, when solar module manufacturers are offering around 25 years of the service life, however, a solar system, which is a bouquet of a PV module, inverter, and other components, and the service life of this product or this system depends on the quality of other products, wherein the inverter is also a part of it. Very well said somewhere it is that as heart pumps the pure blood inside the body and body remains healthy. Very similarly, inverter is one which converts DC current into the AC current, and if able to successfully export in the grid, it will be the healthy for the system, and it will be in time to come healthy for the nation also. Otherwise, tomorrow there will be another engineers after 10 years would be working on how to control and do the filtering of the harmonic distortions. It would be the message or it would be the matter of concern. Currently, when we look at it and we throughout the day, we have listened a lot to the noteworthy officers as well as the, you know, those who are having their own knowledge and experts. Everyone talks about panel and the system and all. A product which has got a 25 years of the life and very less it has been spoken, and I heard also about the inverter. So it has also its own, it is own weightage and due respect to be given to that also.
Fair enough, inverter. Mr. Abhishek, as an EPC, how do you perceive the current status of the modules that are being supplied, right? There's a lot of discussion that has already happened on the fact that there have been ultra-low bids coming in with the question of using Tier 2, Tier 3 materials, right, in terms of facing pressures from your own customers. How are you looking at this problem?
Well, actually what I feel is that the module prices are already on the downturn. But maybe the larger module manufacturers must have anticipated that the prices may be under pressure. So almost before 2-3 months, the prices have been upscaled, and again now they are being downscaled. So that they are actually at their last year's, more than last year's price level. But actually if we see really in non-DCR, the price of modules is still reducing, because majorly whenever new technology comes, the manufacturers develop a safe product, and it is beyond means. They also consider more than the factor of safety, and they design any product. But once the product starts running, we get to know that actual factor of safety is not that much required. So after that, every product design optimization starts. So now in case of modules, actually it is not a new technology, it is quite old, means more than 30 years or so. So ideally the prices of the modules are on the down, really on the downtrend, but artificially they have been upscaled by few of the companies, which I cannot mention from this stage. So actually, it is occurring due to the economies of the scale everywhere, because if you compare before 10 years, the demand of the module and today the demand of the module, both in India as well as in China and Europe. Before 10 years, the demand was only in European countries and American countries. Now China has surpassed everyone, and it started late even after India. But it has rapidly upscaled its installation and all capacities. So it is a very good sign for renewable energy sector that it is coming in so much volume that price reduction is possible at all levels, be it solar panels, be it inverters, be it in the installation technologies and O&M also. Because the volumes which we are getting nowadays were not available before 5 years or 10 years.
You mentioned the fact that there is some sort of an artificial price escalation that I'm noticing. How much of it do you think is because of the anti-dumping duties that came in?
Basically, what I believe is that there is some kind of defect in our policy. In Chinese countries, what they do is they don't apply tax at every level. But in India, because our tax collection system is not that efficient, so it is more concentrated that whoever pays the tax, collect more from them. So at all levels, whether we are paying our payments to suppliers or labor contractors, we have to deduct the TDS. So at every stage, there is a pessimism generated that agar mera 100 rupiya milta tha, to koi contractor ko mujhe 100 rupiya dena hota hai, to mujhe 1 rupiya kaat ke dena hai, 1 rupiya, 5 rupiya, jo bhi TDS hai. So it generates pessimism at all levels. Similarly, anti-dumping duty is also not a, it is just to avoid the situation for some temporary some time. It is not the permanent solution. So ideally, government should incentivize on the production. Means ek taraf se aap GST lagate ho, hum EPC koi bhi hum abhi jo rooftop lagate hai, uspe we are paying 8.9% GST. Aur baad mein uske upar hum subsidy de rahe 30%. बराबर तो और उसका इंटरेस्ट भी हम पे कर रहे हैं तो एक्चुअली तो रियल में देखें तो सिस्टम में पैसा खाली गोल ही घूम रहा है एक्चुअली इट इज़ नॉट इवन 10 or 12% और अगर ये सब सब्सिडी और फाइनेंसिंग के जो हर्डल्स जो हमारे ऊपर आते हैं एज ए EPC वो हटा दे तो एक्चुअली वो 30% में से एक्चुअली खाली 5% ही फर्क पड़ता होगा ऐसा मेरा मानना है
एक हम GST बढ़ते हैं 8.9% लाइक यू मेंशन अपार्ट फ्रॉम द फैक्ट दैट इफ यू आर इंपोर्टिंग मॉड्यूल्स एज इट इज पेइंग एंटी डंपिंग ड्यूटी ऑन इट इफ यू नॉट इंपोर्टिंग द डोमेस्टिक मैन्युफैक्चरर्स हैव सॉर्ट ऑफ मेड श्योर द प्राइसेस आर वेयर दे आर वर्सेस यू कुड हैव बीन मे बी 20% लोअर राइट विदाउट एंटी डंपिंग ड्यूटी सो यू हैव नॉट 20% आउट देयर प्लस द GST कैन नॉट बी क्लेम्ड एज इनपुट देन यू हैव द एडिशनल कॉस्ट ऑफ नेट मीटरिंग एक्सेट्रा सो इन टोटल your project cost is about 30 to 40% is actually going towards in some form or the other either to the government or to the DISCOM which actually inflates the price and then giving a subsidy on it so sort of making a neutral stance on it so definitely there is some validity to that point however I think there has been a lot of communication already sent across and I'm sure the government is well aware of this and we'll definitely be taking some initiatives based upon those inputs right moving forward I think in today's discussion we've not really touched a lot about bilateral captive open access in Gujarat so any comments on that Mr. Abhishek
Open access is also actually at present there is some policy flaw means at present first they were allowing 50% of the contract demand means if anybody has a 100 kilowatt load on that you can install only 50% means actually the solar power works only for 6 hours practically if we see so actually already it is at 25% out of 24 hours only 6 hours we are getting solar power and of that 20% 25% you are giving only 50% to install solar so whoever installs a solar power plant is means MSME or whoever is the factory owner or commercial premises owner does not get to see the real benefit like how he does to get seen this residential sector so as the targets now government is also under pressure from central government because Mr. Modi is very clear that agar mera paisa agar if we are paying to Middle East countries in the form of import bills and all then why not give promote our renewable energy and make energy security for next 25 to 30 years so ये इधर भी एक प्रॉब्लम है तो अभी गवर्नमेंट क्या है कि प्रेशर में है लोकल गवर्नमेंट्स जैसे कि गुजरात गवर्नमेंट ना उनका टारगेट अभी अचीव नहीं हो रहा है रूफटॉप इज 99% बेस्ड ऑन सब्सिडी ओनली तो उससे कोई सब्सिडी इज मेंट टू जस्ट एज ए इंसेंटिव और मार्केटिंग थिंग कि अगर 1 lakh या 2 lakh घर पे सोलर पैनल लगेगा So it will generate a momentum and afterwards subsidy will not be required. But agar ye subsidy ko 100% hatana hai, to industry wale to sabhi ready hai, unko karna hi hai. Lekin ye contract demand ka load jo laye the, usse problem ho raha hai. Recently abhi wo MSME ke liye hata hai, par uske liye bhi proper GR aur proper guidelines abhi tak nahi aaye. It is almost more than 2 or 3 months. since this was announced but why ek hai matlab top level pe there is a willingness but bottom level pe jo वो परकोलेट होना चाहिए वो नहीं हो रहा है अभी भी तो इट इज टेकिंग वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम
मिस्टर धानी
टू ऐड दिस लाइक लॉट ऑफ मनी इन दैट form or under the banner of subsidy or incentives are being provided to promote the renewable energy. Just for a minute, if you take a pause and think that government of Gujarat has a very ambitious program to have 200,000 installations and average we consider as a 3 kilowatt, 600 megawatt. And if we consider the same it further with the help of the calculator, if it is 50 rupees, per watt. So it's a 3,000 crore rupees of the business and average 40% if we consider as the subsidy, it would be around 1,200 crore rupees. Now 200,000 installations and there could be only beneficiaries maximum per family 5 members. So it's 1 million people. 1 million people will have the advantage out of the 1,200 crore rupees of the incentive or the subsidy. When we think government putting aside as a Gujarat the total population is just 650 lakhs of the inhabitants 10 lakh are going to be the benefited that's just 2% and the incentive is 1200 crore rupees so that's a huge amount being pumped in by the government of India and if we really do not take the same thing in a good spirit, probably we would be ruining our hard-earned paid tax. And government is very again ambitious that there will be the similar program month after year after year. So there will be a huge incentive would be into the system and all GST, TDS, income tax paid by all people would be again going to the very few handful people. Honest lies on us, my dear friend, a service life, considered as a service life over 25 years for the rooftop. Please ensure it should be capable to deliver its objective, its performance to the at least 80% of its service life. Failing which, our next generation will not forgive us that you people have spent your own hard-earned money for such a junk of the material which you have imported without any entry barrier. Last time that the fellow Ankit or Amit was saying, Sadiwala got into this system and he has snatched his two orders. But today, a Sadiwala can import a couple of containers and sell that product as an inverter where DCR is not appearing, emerging anywhere, nobody talks about. What will happen? So those Sadiwala will import inverter, they will sell it. There is no specific reference standards or anything. Will it last the services or the rooftop system will deliver it for the 25 years? And again, all of us, whosoever have paid huge money towards that incentive, they have all the right to think on it. In the holistic way, right from the morning till evening, I was listening and thinking. It's like somewhere, Animesh, it's like something, it's the situation of a patient. It's under the hands of a doctors and the pharmaceutical company. They want that patient should not die and also remain sick throughout its service life. It's somewhere down the line. So every manufacturer talks about their reasoning and the positioning and the constraints and lobbying and all that, what we are talking. And the mediator or they are the pharmaceutical manufacturing company. The doctors like EPC or the fraternity or what wearing the tie people like us are ensuring that there is a sufficient bottom line. So is the top line. The government is focusing on this issue. Government is focusing on this initiative. They are pumping in the money. Government is determined. Modi is firm on that. So let's have something new. Let's be diversified. We take the advantage. ये कहीं ऐसा ना हो बहती गंगा में हाथ धो ले। हालात तो ये है, वो 4,000 करोड़ के बाद भी खर्च करने के बाद गंगा क्लीन नहीं हुई और अभी वो कार्यक्रम चालू है। सिमिलर इट में हैपन मे बी 2025 और विद दी एक्स वाई जी गीगावाट आर इंस्टॉल्ड। थैंक यू।
वेरी नाइस पॉइंट्स मिस्टर दानी। कपल ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस। आई थिंक थ्रू आउट द डे वी ऑल हर्ड पीपल टॉकिंग टू द गवर्नमेंट एंड गिविंग देम फीडबैक। आई कम फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र टू बी ऑनेस्ट एंड वी हैव वी आर एक्टिव इन 7 स्टेट्स टुडे एंड टू बी ऑनेस्ट वी सप्लाई पावर टू द स्टेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बोर्ड्स एज वेल टू द डिस्कॉम्स एज वेल एज ऑपरेट ऑन द प्राइवेट स्पेस। टू गिव क्रेडिट यू नो आई थिंक गुजरात डिस्कॉम्स एंड माइंडसेट इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉलिसी हैज बीन वेरी वेरी प्रोग्रेसिव राइट। इफ यू लुक एट द पेमेंट साइकिल्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम गुजरात एंड कर्नाटका डिस्कॉम्स यू डोंट सी अदर डिस्कॉम्स पेइंग ऑन टाइम राइट। इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉलिसी फ्रेमवर्क देर इज मोर क्लैरिटी, देर इज मोर स्टेबिलिटी टू इट। दे आर वेरी क्लियर दिस इज वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू डू, दिस वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू। इट्स नॉट दैट एवरी 2 or 3 ईयर्स इज अ मेजर पॉलिसी फ्लॉप विच अफेक्ट्स एवरीबडी इन्वॉल्व। सो आई थिंक दिस अ लॉट ऑफ क्रेडिट ड्यू टू देम इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिजिटलाइजेशन एज वेल। यू नो वी एम्बार्क्ड ऑन अ जर्नी ऑफ कलेक्टिंग डेटा फॉर द एंटायर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मार्केट इन इंडिया एंड व्हाट वी फाउंड आउट इनिशियली दैट ओनली गुजरात एंड कर्नाटका हैड डिजिटल सिस्टम्स इन प्लेस दैट वर एबल टू सप्लाई द डेटा इन अ रेडी फॉर्मैट। मैनी स्टेट्स अंटिल अ फ्यू इयर्स अगो वर स्टिल रनिंग ऑन हैंड रिटन सिस्टम्स एंड इट इज एक्सट्रीमली सरप्राइजिंग हाउ एंटायर स्टेट्स ग्रिड सॉर्ट ऑफ वाज मैनेज्ड ऑन फोन कॉल्स कि पार्क बंद करो राइट। सो देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ क्रेडिट ड्यू टू देम राइट। ऑब्वियसली नो मैटर हाउ मच यू डू देयर इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी स्कोप फॉर मोर इम्प्रूवमेंट एंड आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाट द डिस्कशन इज। एंड मिस्टर दानी पॉइंट आउट वेरी राइटली दैट इफ यू आर गिविंग सब्सिडीज दैट सब्सिडी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम आवर टैक्स पेड मनी राइट। इट इज नॉट मनी कमिंग आउट ऑफ थिन एयर एंड इफ द सब्सिडी इज गिवन एट लीस्ट यू शुड इंश्योर द प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ 25 ईयर्स इज लुक्ड एट अ 25 ईयर एंगल। द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम इज दैट वी लुक एट फ्रॉम अ शॉर्ट टर्म पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ 5 ईयर्स विच इज व्हाट द टेंडर्स ऑल्सो क्लियरली स्टेट। सेकेंडली देयर सॉर्ट ऑफ बीन कंसर्न एज टू देर आर 550-600 प्लेयर्स इन द मार्केट। सम साड़ी वाला कम्स पुट्स अप अ सोलर प्लांट। आई थिंक इन टर्म्स ऑफ बींग अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री दिस इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एवरी वन टू स्टार्ट देर ओन बिजनेस राइट। हाउएवर एट लीस्ट ऑन द गवर्नमेंट साइड विच इज ऑलवेज बीन मोदी जीज विजन एज वेल वी नॉट इन द गवर्नमेंट टू रन बिजनेस वी इन द गवर्नमेंट टू रेगुलेट राइट। आई थिंक मोर पॉलिसी फ्रेमवर्क अराउंड द क्वालिटी ऑफ सिस्टम्स राइट पुटिंग मोर स्ट्रिंजेंट मैकेनिज्म्स एज टू हु इज अलाउड टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दोस टेंडर्स मेकिंग श्योर दैट अ सर्टेन टीम साइज सर्टेन हिस्ट्री इज अटैच्ड टू इट। इफ फॉर न्यू पीपल यू हैव एन ओपन कैटेगरी राइट लेट देम give them a couple of years to build up their capabilities and perform. Secondly, studies on the actual installations that have happened. Now, because of a database, I can tell you that the thin film projects, which had those 15 rupee PPAs, right? After 6-7 years, they've seen massive amount of degradation. You're looking at least 10-12% degradation, if not more. Many projects have, in fact, been shut down. Some are still operational, right? But then, that is money as good as lost, right? The entire idea was to promote solar. The entire idea was that the plant would run for 25 years, right? There's a technology risk involved. Many plants have actually performed well. The plants that have not performed well, there are many factors that go into it. However, those factors have not been paid attention to despite the data already being available at the government's end. And I think more focus on that aspect because we have a history of 6-7 years. That should become the basis for the next set of policies to be coming up. Polycrystalline has been out there for 2 or 3 years. It's not enough time to decide whether degradation has been there or not, because usually all modules up to the first 5 years perform pretty much on the same lines, right? It's only after the 5th year you start seeing degradation develop in these modules. So at least a focus on that aspect, right, is definitely required. And as an industry, I think whether you're an EPC, you're a developer, whoever you are as part of this industry, I think it's up to us to properly educate the consumer as to what is happening, right? आपको मर्सिडीज मारुति के भाव में नहीं मिल सकता. अगर कोई बोल रहा है कि मर्सिडीज मारुति के भाव में मिल रहा है तो आप भी सोचिए कि मारुति के भाव में क्यों मिल रहा है. What is tier one? You say Bloomberg tier one list, but is Bloomberg telling you it's a quality parameter? They're not saying that. They're saying कितना sales हुआ है, right? So I think as an industry, it's very important as to how we pitch, how we educate the consumers, because the Indian mentality is कि सस्ते से सस्ता लेना है, right? But ये भी जानना जरूरी है कि वो सस्ता चीज eventually over 25 years महंगा पड़ने वाला है कि सस्ता रहने वाला है.
ये इंडियन मेंटालिटी के बारे में जो अनिमेश ने कहा, सस्ते से सस्ता लेना है, वही हमारे दोस्त सस्ते से सस्ता कहीं से ढूंढ के भी लेके आते हैं और कुछ ऐसा ही दे देते हैं जो सस्ते से सस्ता से मिलता जुलता है.